2019 European Continental Cup on twitch.tv live from Helsinki, Finland, hosted by Kallio Rolling Rainbow and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. I am Loud and Queer.
And I am Riggs. And we are here to welcome you to the final Continental Cup of the season, our 2019 European Cup. After this event, our next live Twitch show will be from the Championships in Montreal, Quebec, in Canada, which will be held between November the 15th to the 17th. If you want to learn more about the WFTDA postseason and how you can watch or attend any of our events in person, head on over to the Tournament Central on WFTDA.com to see all of the events listed. Also today, if you haven't brought your WFTDA.tv watch passes yet, we're going to give away two watch passes today in the Twitch raffle, so stay tuned.
And if you're new to roller derby, you can head on over to WFTDA.tv to watch our roller derby one-on-one videos. You can also find them in the chat. The one-on-one videos will explain the basics of roller derby, the rules, the number of players, and so on. We're actually going to show you one of them right now about how the game of flat track roller derby is played.
Roller derby is played in increments called jams. Each jam lasts up to 2 minutes. Both teams field up to five skaters at the start of the jam. Four of these skaters are called blockers, and one is called the jammer. The jammer wears a helmet cover with a star on it and scores points for the team. The blockers are playing both offense and defense at the same time, and together they make up what is called the pack. The two jammers start each jam behind the pack and must get through all of these skaters for an initial pass before they can begin to score points. When the initial pass is complete, a jammer can score 1 point for every opponent they pass with their hips. The first jammer out of the pack legally is declared lead jammer, which means they can end the jam anytime they want before the 2 minutes are up. Sounds easy, right?
Gave you a bit of a taste, if you've never seen roller derby, of what to expect. It is a fast and furious game. Of course, you can ask us questions in the Twitch chat room if you have any questions about the game. And today's game has all kinds of other fun involved. As Rig said, we've got some watch pass giveaways at halftime, and of course our roller derby quiz, so you can test your knowledge of WFTDA gameplay and history. We'll be playing along with that as well.
Absolutely, I have done so well so far on those quizzes. Not. And if you guys have never seen the game before, or you've never been to a WFTDA tournament, here's a little slice of what you've been missing from some of our other playoff events.
And what you saw in those clips are a variety of teams from throughout the WFTDA. But we are bringing you just two teams today in a singular matchup on twitch.tv. We are going to be watching Dublin Roller Derby face off against Auld Reekie Roller Derby. Dublin Roller Derby are, of course, from Dublin, Ireland, and they are the number one seed in this tournament, and they're currently ranked at 31 in the world in the WFTDA rankings. Auld Reekie Roller Derby are from Edinburgh, Scotland. They have come into the tournament as the number four seed and are currently ranked 42 in the world in the WFTDA rankings. But something you should know, even if, especially if you've never seen roller derby before, is that there can be upsets. You know, we might see the lower seed triumph over the higher seed. Anything can happen in roller derby, which is what is so exciting about it. Right now, we are going to take you through the rosters so that you know who is going to be playing on your screens.
So let me introduce you to Dublin Roller Derby, who will be playing in white today. We have 05, Vegan Fox, 123, Maria Von Slap, 169, Brudol E. Locock, 17, Dirty Knees Louise, 23, Greenhole Cooney, number 3, Voldemort, number 47, AK, number 490, Malibruze Stacy, 53, Argy Bargy, 575, Pippa, 74, Stabber, 8, Chancletta, 83, Dashing Trudy Snow, 90, Lana Plain, and number 95, Mangia.
And playing in the green today for Auld Reekie Roller Derby is 00, Temple of Doom, 11, Crazy Legs, 12, Simply the Beast, 17, Emka, 19, Miss Kolicek, 23, Cirque du Soleil, 269, Tenacious C, 29, Booga, 360, Kamitazi, 39, Bangers, 612, Crash Collision Course, 626, Sasha DeBoyle Pisco, 7, Jess Little, 77, Charlotte Patterson, and 9, Mallory Powers.
So, for those of you who are new to Twitch, make sure you sign up for your Twitch account and are able to access the chat. We can see a few of you in there. Hello, Elf Indulgence. Lovely to see you with us this morning. We're going to raffle off some watch passes later in the broadcast. So you need to be signed up and chatting with us in order to make that happen.
And if you want to subscribe to our channel, you can watch all of our previous content as well as this game on our WFTDA Twitch channel. Especially again in the chat room, if you are in the Derby community, please tell your Derby friends to get on the chat so that they can throw their support to either team. We'd really, really love to have you with us. And if you're new to Roller Derby and are really excited to be watching your first ever game, please do ask us questions. We will get back to you as soon as possible. We're hoping to give you a really, really fantastic game. Both these teams have played already in this tournament today. So Dublin Roller Derby coming in as the number one seed. There was a bit of an upset earlier, Riggs, wasn't there?
We've had some upsets.
So earlier on this morning, Dublin lost to the tournament 8 seed Antwerp Roller Derby. And earlier on, Auld Reekie lost to the number 5 seed. That was Perth Roller Derby, all the way from Australia. So both teams coming in quite tired, probably from those earlier games, but really, really excited. They are old rivals, these two. They have met each other on track many a time.
Absolutely. And I will have to say, I mean, I've watched both of those games this morning, and Auld Reekie took on Perth, who were incredibly physical. That seemed to be a much more physical game than the Dublin Antwerp game. So that could be an interesting factor as we go ahead with this second game for both teams today.
I mean, you say it's a very physical game, Riggs, but of course, roller derby, for those of you new to it, it is a contact sport. You know, this is one of the first things you're told when you start in roller derby. You'll be seeing a lot of pushing and shoving on track, but it is all very controlled. There are many rules to keep the pushing and shoving and the contact safe. And to enforce those rules, we have a number of officials. You can see in the right-hand side of your screen there, some people wearing black and white striped shirts. Those are our skating officials, known affectionately in the community as zebras. And there are 7 of them skating around, all doing a different job to enforce the rules, keep score and so on.
So if you are new to roller derby and you need a bit more information on what's going on here, how to play roller derby, the rules, the penalties, and this particular event, please visit wftda.com/new.
Nice little shot of some of our skating officials in the middle there. That is Squid, Feminist Killjoy, Empower, Shugs Bunny, Temeraire, Divide by Zero, and Cluster Schmuck. Those are our skating officials today. and we'll take you through our non-skating officials later and perhaps tell you a bit more about what those wonderful folks do.
So we have got 30 minutes on the clock for the first half of this game. And round the outside, Charlotte Patterson, does not get lead and immediately visits the penalty box for a track cut.
This is quite a common penalty for jammers, and it also gives the opposing team, who have their jammers still on track, a power jam. Dashing Trudy Snow is now the unopposed jammer on track. She leaps through the pack and picks up lead jammer status for Dublin.
So Dashing Trudy Snow is on a scoring pass now. Will score 1 point for the hips of every blocker they pass on the track. So Dashing Trudy Snow has pushed through that tripod at the front, and you will see the tripod as a common defense tactic.
In the meantime, Charlotte Patterson coming out of the box, heads into the pack. She is still trying to complete her initial pass through the pack of blockers, the first pass you must make before you become eligible to score any points.
So now everybody's eligible for points, and the whole point of having lead jammer status is it gives you control of the jam. So as you can see there, before Auld Reekie could get in and score any points, Dublin called the jam with that lovely set of taps to the hips, which indicate that the jam is being called.
Nice to see some interaction on the Twitch chat already. Slamity99 saying Dashing Trudy Snow is 100% the best name in the game. Controversial, there are a lot of names in roller derby.
Oh, I don't know, but Dashing Trudy Snow.
Dashing Trudy Snow is, to be fair, one of my favourite players, and it's a great name. But the jammers of the right now, Greenhall Cooney for Dublin, Sasha Deboer Pisco for Auld Reekie.
And we see that both sets of blockers had locked down on their jammers, and oh my days, it's the second power jam in favour of Auld Reekie, as the Dublin block jammers have picked up track cut penalties in the opening two jams.
So that's one power jam apiece already. We're only in jam two. Of course, it gives the team with the jammer on track a huge strategic advantage, as their blockers can focus solely on offence, getting their jammer through without having to concentrate on defending against the opposing jammer.
So Sasha did really well there to avoid the goated blocker from Dublin, who was hanging at the back there. That was Valdemort. But you can see a no pass, no penalty indicated. So only picking up 3 of the 4 available points for Sasha on that pass.
We see a couple of big hits to the outside there. Sasha barely breaking stride as she puts up an additional 4 points on her second scoring run.
Greenhall Cooney, though, comes through, completes the initial by stashing the star, which is where you remove it from your helmet in a hope of tricking all the blockers into thinking you're not the jammer.
Yeah, roller derby may look like just a lot of fast getting around the track, but it is a cerebral game full of tactics and strategy, which is one of the many, many reasons that it's so much fun.
Absolutely. These blockers are going to be playing defense and offense at the same time. Well, sometimes at the same time. Sometimes they'll do one or the other. But we see number 360, Kamitazi, take the line for Auld Reekie.
And she is up against number 47, AK, who had an absolute blinder of a game earlier against Antwerp.
Oh, an absolute storming game from AK earlier, who was fantastic. Cammy had a really tough time against the Perth Wolves. They were incredibly tough. So Cammy will be looking to make as much progress as possible, but Dublin might have been studying Perth. So Jess Little there with the drawback on AK.
Jess Little, one of the several players on Auld Reekie, who is also a national team skater. She skated for Team Scotland in the last World Cup. We have some Team Scotland and some Team Ireland skaters out there. This is actually supposedly been called the Battle of the Celtics on by Auld Reekie on their social media right now, and it really is pretty appropriate to describe it as that.
So we've got a forearms penalty being called there, and that is to the Dublin blocker. That was Lana Payne, now taking a 30-second sit in the box.
And AK was out of the pack there, but did not obtain lead status. Kamitazi made it out of the pack at the, just then and called it off. There's just some conversation going on between the Dublin bench and the JAMA referee about that. Sometimes you see the JAMA can make it out of the pack without obtaining lead status on something called a no pass, no penalty.
We are going to have an official timeout now while we just look into this situation. So thank you for joining us on our Twitch stream today. If you want to see more excellent roller derby, please visit wftda.tv/watch-pass to find out how you can watch the rest of this event and our championships in November live from the comfort of your home. Or you can get yourself on our Twitch chat, yeah, and then you can enter the raffle for one of the watch passes that we will be giving away. And we're giving away two of those.
Yes, there's one watch pass, which is going to give one lucky person access to this entire weekend event. The second watch pass, which is up for grabs, is for the entire WFTDA postseason, including the archives. So you do not want to miss that chance.
So Charlotte Patterson is your lead jammer of reckoning for Auld Reekie. But Dashing Through the Snow is about half a lap behind. Oh, an excellent footwork there. Almost able to stay inbound with Charlotte Patterson. Not quite, but picks up three and shuts the play down before Dublin can pick up any points.
This is a lovely close game right now. Auld Reekie sitting at 11 points. Dublin holding at four. We have 24 minutes and 16 seconds to go in the half. Roller derby is played in two 30-minute halves. The only time when the clock will stop is for team timeouts or official reviews. We will discuss those as and when they occur.
So 1-7, Emka is out there for Auld Reekie, going up against 0-5, Vegan Fox for Dublin. And it is Auld Reekie who come up with lead once more. So we have Emka in position and in control of the lead.
Vegan Fox, in the meantime, working away on this Auld Reekie defense, which looks pretty brutal from where I'm standing. You can see all of Auld Reekie's blockers going into that defensive formation and pushing Vegan Fox to the infield. She therefore has to recycle, come back on track legally, and try again.
So Vegan Fox is really being locked down right now. Still between turns one and two. But as I say that, typical commentator's curse. Vegan Fox finds room on the outside. There was none, but the toe stop work kept her in.
Emka calling the jam there. Our fantastic producer, Sven Will Be Famous, has very kindly reminded me that Emka is actually a skater for Team Poland. We saw them at the last London Thunder Roller Derby World Cup, which was actually held in Manchester during February 2018.
And it did have an awful lot less lines on the floor than you guys are seeing now. So though for those of us in the UK and kind of across Europe, we like to put all of the lines on our floors in our sports halls. And so these blockers are totally used to it. All they are going to see right now is that black and yellow tape, and they will know exactly where they are.
Kamitazi and Greenhall Cooney. And Kamitazi picks up lead for Auld Reekie, but is taken to the inside of the track and has to reset behind Maniha and try once again to make that initial pass.
The 490 Malib Bruce Stacy doing an excellent job of just driving Kamitazi off the track.
Greenhall Cooney, in the meanwhile, not having much luck against this Auld Reekie wall, who are moving laterally, so from side to side of the track, not giving her any space.
And we see number 12, Beastie, coming in for Auld Reekie, trying to break things up and set Kamitazi free.
Lovely offense there by Beastie. Gives Kamitazi just one to be at the front, so she now completes the initial pass as lead jammer.
But Greenhall Cooney took three different hits then and still managed to stay inbound. It was fantastic as we see Kamitazi jumping across, just trying to sneak those last couple of points, and does so. 4 points for Auld Reekie, shutting it down for Dublin, who are held on four. So we have Auld Reekie on a bit of a streak right now. They've held Dublin scoreless for the last five jams, and they've had lead for those as well.
Yeah, so Dublin really needs to be getting back into scoring position if they've got a hope of challenging the team from Scotland. And hoping to do that is AK from Dublin. up against Sasha de Boyle Pisco in this jam.
Oh, but coming to a dead stop at the entrance of turn one there. That was some serious tough work. And we have a penalty and a power jam. It was a track cut picked up there by Sasha. So Dublin with AK, who is one of their most successful jammers this morning, in the lovely position of being on a power jam.
As AK comes around into turn two, you see Auld Reekie setting up their wall at the front of the pack, hoping to stick together. But here comes that Dublin offense sweeping in, trying to disrupt that structure.
The year of the shirt work is upon us. And we have that multiplayer being called. Yep, so a multiplayer block being called on AK-47. And that releases Sasha from the box because we must have a jammer on track.
Quite unusual to have a multiplayer called on a jammer. Quite often it's when a jammer grabs the shirt or perhaps at the arm of one of their blockers to try to help them through. But it forms an impenetrable link, which is not allowed in roller derby. This means, of course, Riggs, what happens to the time in this jam?
This time in this jam will go for the full 2 minutes. And I can tell you something, the jammers love a two-minute jam.
They
really do. Never, don't look at their faces after it, but they absolutely love this moment. And, oh, great battle between the jammer and the pivot. That was number 53, Argy Bargy, living up to their name.
AK returning to track and coming in hot to that Auld Reekie tripod at the back. Sasha taken to the outside and coming back on. And another penalty going to Sasha, another cut track. Oh my goodness me.
The jammer's come to an end and the Auld Reekie jammer is in the box. This will give Dublin a power start as we go into this next jam. It means they're going to be unopposed on the line. It means all of the blockers are going to be able to be there to support dashing Trudy Snow on her way through the pack, hopefully.
I really enjoy a power jam because it just makes me think of like something like Mario, where you know you power up. And of course, having that jammer go to the box at the end of the jam gives the full 30 seconds to work with at the start.
So our scores right now are 8 Dublin, 23 to Auld Reekie, but dashing Trudy Snow will be hoping that this power jam will allow them to close that differential somewhat.
Dashing Trudy Snow, an absolute veteran for Dublin roller derby, as well as Team Ireland, settles down her team as she comes in to set up the offensive manoeuvre.
So we are now back to a full complement of jammers on the track as Sasha exits the box and comes round. And just a little tap to say hello to that Dublin tripod. So this is a very effective defensive manoeuvre. You can see there, two blockers at the back just locking together. Of course, they can't form an impenetrable bond, but they can get pretty close.
Like atoms. Oh, look at me trying to bring science into roller derby. I probably shouldn't do that. Oh, a star pass is attempted there by Sasha de Boyle Pisco. You can see the helmet cover on the ground. She's now picked it back up and was trying to pass it off to her pivot, but it did not happen.
But dashing Trudy Snow took a moment just to assess options and took a very patient line through the pack there to pick up 4 points. And we have some defensive jamming. And Sasha comes around just ahead of dashing through the snow.
Yeah, smart move there, defensive jamming wise. You know, jammers can actually hit each other at any point on the track. They don't have to be within the engagement zone that the blockers have to be. But it's a high risk to place a hit directly on that jammer in case it goes wrong. But however, eating up the space in front of them and just cutting off their speed a little bit can be highly effective.
So 8 points picked up by Dublin in that jam, takes them to 16. Auld Reekie, now scoreless in that last one, are still on 23.
In the meantime, Charlotte Patterson and Greenhall Cooney are jamming for their respective teams.
See a big recycle there. That's number 90, Lana Payne, taking Charlotte Patterson right back almost to the jam line and now locking down on the Auld Reekie jammer.
You can see number 39, that's bangers for Auld Reekie, kind of hanging out in the middle of the pack, sometimes going back as she's doing now. and then sometimes going up to the front to provide the offense, a really useful strategy there.
But this is quite the scrum we've got at the entrance of Term 1. And if you've been watching the Rugby World Cup, you'll be thinking to yourself, I've seen a lot of this recently. But no, this is just what happens when the blockers are on fine form and are able to contain the jammers. But of course, there we go, I say it again. Oh, it wasn't quite the commentator's curse because that was a track cut that was picked up by Charlotte Patterson.
I think I'm correct in saying, and Sven will correct me if I'm wrong, that every single jammer penalty so far has been a track cut. I'm wrong, Sven, aren't I?
There was that multiplayer. That was that multiplayer.
See, oh, I knew. I was just keeping you awake, Riggs. I was just keeping you awake. But that is, the second track cut for Charlotte Patterson.
There was a beautiful hit there from... Oh, wasn't that beautiful, because it has resulted in a penalty, but it did slow Greenhawken down just a little bit.
Greenhawken now picking up 4 points on that pass for Dublin. But is going to be taken back into turn two by the Auld Reekie blockers.
Both jammers on the outside line looking for their matrix moves, but it is Greenhawken who comes through there and picks up 4 points.
And with that, we see a lead change. Dublin now at 24 points, Auld Reekie at 23. Oh my goodness me.
And Greenhall there was just hanging in on one skate, trying to stay inbound, and just stares at the jammer ref, like, surely I got me some points there, but nope.
I'm just having a quick look at our Twitch chat room. Oh, somebody said always a fan of Loud and Queer. That's me, which is very kind of you. But please do encourage people to jump in with questions. We've got Derby fan Q saying, come on, Dublin.
So
we've got a Dublin fan in the chat room.
But just a quick one for you. So Dublin were held scoreless for the first five jams, and they've just put up 20 points in the last three jams. Look at that maths on the fly there, people.
Oh, quick maths, Ruth, quick maths. And speaking of facts and figures, do you know how many member leagues the WFTDA have, Riggs? Off the top of your head.
I absolutely don't, and I'd have to take my shoes off to count, I think, wouldn't I?
Well, I can tell you that the WFTDA have 460 member leagues. The Women's Flat Track Derby Association is the international governing body of roller derby. And if you're interested in joining one of those 460 member leagues, then you can find out more about how to play, where to play, and about all those leagues at wftda.com/new. See the players lining up, the referees just having a quick discussion in the middle during that timeout, popping their water bottles back and then getting ready to go into jam number 10 of this first half.
Emma Cat for Auld Reekie is out there and is very ready to face off against 05 Vegan Fox for Dublin. Very tight on the line, but there are two in the box for Auld Reekie, so they are at a pack deficit. Two up front with a one Dublin player in there trying to play offense for Vegan Fox, but this two wall doing an incredible job. That's number 23, Cirque de Slay in there, along with the captain. Number 11, Crazy Legs. What a two wall.
And Vegan Fox just taking that inside line with zero opposition. Lovely work there.
So we're now back to 3-on-3 in the pack.
Vegan Fox coming in again on a scoring pass, fighting her way through.
The MCA there thought there was some room for an opportunity after being hit off, but coming in and shutting the door was Malibu Stacy.
Now we see some of Dublin switch positions, trying to hold off Emka as she breaks through on the initial pass. Just having another look in our chat room at the end of that jam we have. I'd just like to answer one of the questions that knee_UK was asking. Say, is there a puck or a ball? The old adage in roller derby is that there is no ball, but if there was, the jammer or the star cover would be the equivalent. The star is what scores the points in roller derby. It has to be on the head of the player in order to score points. The jammer can pass the star cover off to the pivot. If you look on your screen, number 7 for Auld Reekie is wearing the pivot cover, which is a helmet with a stripe down the center.
If the jammer passes the cover off legally to that player, they become the active jammer and can score points. What else should I say about star passes, Riggs?
Well, I don't think we need to say an awful lot more about star passes. They're a great tactic if your jammer is unable to get out of the pack. Your pivot will often be loitering at the front of the pack for a quick exit, and it's a great way to be able to call the jam or force the call of the jam. So we've just had a bit of an official timeout, and we are going to be starting this next jam with Emka in the penalty box. So it was a forearm that got Emka in there, and that leaves number 47, AK, on the line, ready to go for Dublin.
So a power start gives this full 30-second advantage to Dublin, and AK can put on quite a turn of speed when she wants to. Here she goes on your screen, flies into bangers.
Now driving.
At the front.
Yeah, driving into that two-wall.
And that's Bangers and Jess Little at the front for Auld Reekie. They're two of the most experienced players. Somehow AK stays in bounds despite that contact and carries on this scoring pass.
Physics was denied there by AK. Facts. So AK is in scoring points now, but is being recycled.
Look at this scrum on the inside line there. Emka coming in with some nice work around the outside line.
So the pack is waiting for Emka, and Emka can't get there before the jam is called and before Dublin have picked up 3 points. So we had a five-streak lead streak for Auld Reekie as we started this game, and now Dublin have turned the momentum in their favour, sitting on a five lead streak themselves right now.
Just answering and or clarifying another question from the chat room from the underscore UK. I can see a couple of responses already asking, can roller derby be played outdoors? There are in fact some teams who practice largely outdoors. Dos por Cuatro, the team from Argentina, quite famously really only have an outdoor venue, and there are outdoor tournaments and so on. So thank you so much for that really valuable question.
So as we go back to the action, Dashing Through the Snow is out there for Dublin. Charlotte Patterson is out there for Auld Reekie. We see the pivot going to the box for Auld Reekie, which leaves Charlotte Patterson with no options. We'll have to try and power through, but is trapped behind that beautiful Dublin tripod at the pivot line as we see Dublin picking up lead with Dashing Through the Snow.
Just to clarify as well, you can tell who's lead apart from us telling you by the star that appears next to the jammer names on your score overlay at the bottom of the screen.
So Dashing Through the Snow is back in now on a scoring pass, finds some room on the outside, manages to stay inbound, 1 foot up to counterbalance, and that is 4 points picked up for Dublin.
Dublin really picking up a bit of the momentum in this jam, not letting Auld Reekie rest for a second. And there goes Green Pony with the call off. Again, for anyone who is watching and is perhaps a bit confused, that's fine. Roller derby is a very confusing game. The reason you see the jammers tapping their hands repeatedly to their hips, that is the way that you call off the jam. And you can only do that if you have lead jammer status.
So we are very happy to have you with us today for this fantastic game live on Twitch. If you like what you're seeing, join us for our live free games from the 2019 postseason right here on Twitch. Get the schedule at wftda.tv/Twitch. So it's Kamatazi who is being recycled right now all the way back to the entrance of Turn 4 by Dublin. As we see Greenhawk Cooney up front pushing hard against that. Offense being offered by number 1, 2, 3, Maria von Slapp.
Kamatazi getting a bit of a shot there of Kamatazi's face paint, which is kind of her trademark when she plays roller derby. Managing to stay in bounds despite a big old hit. I think that was from Saba, but I'm not entirely sure.
And that is the first lead in six jams, in fact, for Auld Reekie. So Kamatazi out there trying to turn the tide of this game.
You can see on your screen there,
Kamatazi coming round the turn, tapping her hands to her hips and calls off the jam. Takes some high fives from her pack, from her team of blockers. We have 8 minutes and 19 seconds left in this first half. And of course, don't forget, at the halftime, we've got a fun quiz to test your roller derby brain. And you can get a watch pass in our giveaway, so do stick around for the halftime to listen to Riggs and I talk you through that. Another excuse to listen to our dulcet tones. What more could you want?
So Vegan Fox is out jamming for Dublin right now and is trapped right in between those Auld Reekie blockers. First jam out, I believe, for Crash Collision Course.
It is indeed her first jam out in this game.
And Kale is good for you as long as you're not a Dublin blocker right now. As we see the Dublin pivot on the way to the box, that means there's two out of action blockers for Dublin right now. As we see all the action go backwards.
And no lead yet established. 40 seconds into this jam, and no one is yet in control of that clock.
In fact, I think Vegan Fox is only just now passing the pivot line for the first time.
And Vegan Fox now picking up lead for Dublin roller derby. Comes in with a huge hit on Miss Collie Check.
Check yourself before Vegan Fox wrecks yourself. Facts.
Vegan Fox picking up three on that pass with a no pass, no penalty, but coming in for more. She has got a real turn of speed that is just impossible to convey on screen.
A just big shout out to the Dublin blockers right now who have not let Crash Collision through even as far as the pivot line. In fact, he's actually behind the jam line right now and has spent most of this jam so far stuck in there. A tough first jam for Crash.
You can see Crash has taken the star cover off as well. As we've alluded to before, this might be to try to fake out the opposing blockers, but it's also in the hope of passing it off to the pivot as a star pass. However, the reason that didn't happen there as the jam comes to an end is that the pivot was maintaining the pack. That's the kind of space within which blockers have to be operating in order to block legally. So you can't just move about wherever you want on track and roller derby. There's more rules. There's more rules about just, where you've got to be.
Just one or two.
Elf Indulgence on our Twitch chat is looking forward to the quiz. We do hope you'll stick around for that, Elf Indulgence, to be in with a chance of winning a WFTDA watch pass.
Mcar is your jammer for Auld Reekie and is also your lead jammer after finding a beautiful section of space open up on the inside. We have AK out for Dublin, who is being held right at the top of turn one. Mcar goes through though, picks up 4 points. And so these jammers will do an awful lot of work, but as I like to say, jammers are just collecting points that blockers are making.
As you like to say.
That's what I like to say.
As a blocker, I'd like to agree with you.
It's just because blockers are generally bigger than me, and I feel like it's always a good idea to be on their side. So Mcar being recycled now all the way back between turns 3 and 4.
And a real battle with AK going on in that far straightaway. This blocking duo of Jess Little and number 9, Mallory Powers, just really effective in the last second of that jam.
So we are going to see AK going to the box for a penalty. That was for blocking a downed skater. So power jam start now for Auld Reekie. And it is number 77, Charlotte Patterson, who is going to take that privilege and honour.
Just checking in the chat, blackacid_15. I'm sad that you won't be able to stick around with the quiz. It will only be about 6 minutes long if you can possibly hold on to whatever you've got to do. I'm constantly running late for things because of roller derby, so I'd encourage you to join in that bad behaviour with me.
NG Wolfgamer, you and I are in the same boat. I am not very good at these quizzes, I'm not going to lie.
Riggs and I were chatting earlier because we're gonna talk you through the quiz, but we're gonna have a few goes. But I'm I'm quite competitive and I like getting quiz questions right.
I mean, I'm good at your pub quiz, right? But for some reason, every time I watch these wonderful free streams on Twitch and being in the chat room, cracking on, I've just not done very well. I feel like this is public embarrassment coming my way.
Public embarrassment is my middle name.
Mm-hmm. So we had 5 leads in a row for Auld Reekie as we opened this game. We then went into a 6 lead streak for Dublin. And now the momentum is very much back and forth. The point side of Auld Reekie have been held to some really, really low scores right up until that last jam when they put up 8. In that time, Dublin have been held scoreless 3 times. So it's all to play for right here.
Slamity99, I'm really sorry, but the quiz is not about dogs. Otherwise, I think I would be not concentrating on the roller derby at all because, like, apart from derby, my great love is dogs.
I mean, derby doggos are the best thing, and all tournaments should have more dogs. Fact.
Slamity saying, if it's about derby rules, we're all stuffed. I mean, I don't know. I think that Riggs and I have been really quite good at talking you through some of the rules.
I think the fact that we've got Spend Will I Be Famous as our producer means that if you've got questions about the rules, we will be able to answer them. Don't shake your head at me, Sven.
And by we mean Sven.
We totally mean Sven. So we are ready to go again. And it is Charlotte Patterson on the line for that power jam start. As you remember, AK is in the box for that penalty picked up at the end of that last jam.
A very blended pack off the jam line there, by which I mean there was no discernible structure, like a group of blockers and either team together. But Charlotte Patterson with 1 to beat does make it through 4 leads.
So you guys are watching Auld Reekie now, just trying to separate the Dublin wall ahead of Charlotte Patterson's arrival. They weren't able to do so, so now they're going to pile in and try and offer some offense. But AK is out of the box, and Auld Reekie have to switch immediately back to playing defense.
Look at this score, 55-33. So both palindrome scores. That really pleases me.
We love a palindrome.
Oh, big flying hit there from Charlotte Patterson, who doesn't move the Dublin wall an inch. That is how strong they are. But she pops back out to reattempt the inside.
And we see both jammers contained right now as both walls are going full on defense. That's because Dublin are down a blocker right now. And Charlotte Patterson shrugs off the remaining 3 to pick up 4 more points.
And we're seeing AK have to reset behind a 2 wall of Auld Reekie blockers who are doing some really, really nice work there with just the 2 of them.
So there are 8 points picked up by Auld Reekie in that jam. And in fact, the highest scoring jam we've had so far is 11 points, and that was to Dublin
not very long ago. I mean, speaking of not very long ago, it seemed like only seconds ago that we had 15 minutes left in the half, and we only have 2 now. We are taking the quickest of timeouts, because I hadn't even finished saying it.
So Sasha is out on the line for Auld Reekie. Going to be going up against number 8, Chankletter. No, it's not. It's 83, Dash and Trudy Snow. I only saw the 8. But never mind all of that, because Sasha found a beautiful line through, picked up lead.
And you see Sasha on your screen coming in, ducking around, dashing Judy Stowe to meet the Dublin defensive formation. You can see the Dublin pivot doing that back and forth, offense, defense, check.
So we do have the star pass now. That has gone to number 53, Argy Bargy.
So I was wrong. She wasn't doing the offense-defense check. She was doing the slickest little star pass.
That's how you know it was good. So that was actually the first star pass of the game for Dublin.
It's a tactic which some teams choose to use quite frequently, or certainly have done this tournament. But it is something of a calculated risk, because the pivots, of course, will jam at practice as part of that training quite a lot of the time, but they are primarily blockers.
fact, I need to correct myself because that was the first star pass of the entire game. So, Kamatazi is out for Auld Reekie, going up against Greenhall Cooney.
The battle of the hyphenated names. Mm-hmm. Although I can confirm that Kamatazi is her derby name, not her given name, whereas Greenhall Cooney is skating under her given name.
So Greenhall Cooney is not your lead jammer, got a no pass, no penalty, which meant that Kamatazi was able to pick up lead and gain control of that jam and close it down before any points, well, I say any points can be put up. There is a confab happening between our referees right now just to establish if there were points, and a fist goes up and it means no points were picked up. And we are, oh my days, heading into halftime with a 10-point differential.
How did that happen? What a lovely low-scoring game.
And in fact, it was so low-scoring that Dublin have been held scoreless in the last four jams.
We're going to get you ready in a minute for our quiz. But before we do that, you know, just so we give you a chance to catch your breath and so on. Riggs, what has characterised that first half for you? What have Dublin done that's really impressed you or that's really stood out?
I have to say that the penalties haven't been a huge issue. 14 for Auld Reekie, 18 for Dublin right now. So that's not been the end of the world. But it's the Dublin jammers, I just think, are just smashing through quite well. Not always picking up the points, but, I mean, 10 points in it, this literally could be anyone's game right now.
I think it's, I completely agree with you. I can't call it either way. Not that that's my job. I think for Auld Reekie, what's done it for me has been those two walls that they're able to form. They're really able to block so ably with just two players. But they've had some bad luck with those jammer penalties, which could be critical going into the second half.
Right, so WFTDA Marketing has gone right ahead and created this very fun quiz to test our knowledge of WFTDA roller derby. So let's see how good we are at answering these questions. Please, on the chat, get involved. Let us know what you think the answers are, because we need to let you know. So next up is the WFTDA quiz. It's a non-stop trivia on WFTDA, roller derby, and more. Each question is going to appear for 30 seconds. It'll be followed immediately by the answer for 10 seconds. And there are four categories in the WFTDA quiz. There's a multiple choice. You'll be presented with a selection of answers. Only one of them is correct. The lightning round. This one's easy. Answer the question immediately before the answer appears. And then we have Jeopardy. All answers must be in the form of a question. Lastly, true or false. Determine which statements are true and which ones are false.
I'm just going to shout out to Lightning Slim, who I think was on the chat earlier. If you're not going hard for that lightning question, Lightning Slim, then I don't know who you are anymore.
Right, get ready. Get ready, people. The WFTDA quiz starts right now. You are absolutely right. But right, multiple choice is our first one. Are we ready?
Which is the only Canadian city to host both a WFTDA playoffs and championships event? Toronto, Ontario, Vancouver, British Columbia, Montreal, Quebec, or Calgary, Alberta?
Ooh. I mean, they haven't had it yet, but it's gonna be. So I want to lean towards Montreal. But I feel like I'm wrong.
I don't know. Oh my God.
See, look, Twitch is with me. Everybody feels like C might be it.
It is Montreal! Rich,
that is
you
the
did
first
it.
One.
You
that
did it.
The first
smashed
one
it.
Ever.
Smashed it. I knew you could do it, Riggs. I had faith in you.
Also, our chat room, you guys were all
smashing
over
it also. What is this hand signal and which verbal cue or cues are used with it? A, interference and delay of game. B, low block and illegal contact. Or C, misconduct and insubordination.
I mean, I am not cheating at all by having a little nosy at my refereeing clues down here, because I'm not going to lie, I got a little confused there.
I think it is C. Don't shake your head at me, Sven. I was just going over all the things I know about officiating in my mind. I know about three things, and that was
Twitch, though. You guys are on this.
Lightning round, let's go. Are we ready?
This is good practice for the raffle.
Name the five most common signs of a concussion. This is a cracking question because WFTDA, you have done so much on promoting like awareness of concussion symptoms and so on.
If you don't get this one right, you need to go to wfTDA.com/concussions to find out more information, which is where I need to go because I could not get any of those, frankly, right now, apart from, oh, ow, my head hurts.
I'm going to pretend that I know them all, but I'm not going to say it. Oh, here we go. Positive loss of consciousness or blackout, headaches and sensitivity to light, physical signs such as nausea, vomiting or unsteadiness, impaired brain function such as confusion, and abnormal behavior. What does GTO stand for?
Oh, I know this one. You know this one.
I know it too. I bet I knew it before you though.
I bet you did, true. Come on, Twitch. Let's see if you know what this one is. GTO.
Slamity, I see you out there doing a grand old job on these questions.
So Twitch, what does GTO stand for? That's what we need to know, because I know. This is one of the ones that I know. I'm feeling a little bit smug right now.
We're not going to say it. We're just going to wait a little bit in case there's delay.
There we go. It is the Games Tournament Oversight. A GTO is required for all sanctioned tournaments, and we have a wonderful one here with us here today.
Oh, hi, Scholar O'Hurtier. I see you on the chat. I see you.
So in this role, one acts as an additional eyes and ears to support announcers and feeds them useful information throughout the game. Oh, I'm not going to lie, but there's somebody at this table who feels like he knows the answer.
I can't. Who could that be, Riggs?
I honestly have no idea.
So useful information throughout the game. I mean, we had some of that, I suppose.
Definitely not us, I don't think.
We are the useful information.
What is
a producer? And you must have answered that in a question. Unforeseen consequences, I'm really sorry. What is a dog is tragically not the answer.
So, next question. Since 2016, the WFTDA has been recognizing these. There are air quotes. Okay. I can't do air quotes. Okay, I'm stumped.
I have a thought and a feeling. It's not necessarily linked to this, but WFTDA on the chat is not encouraging behavior. What is a dog?
To be fair, we're all
that
about
is not dog. It's not the answer. What is WFTDA recognized tournaments?
I think right now you can get involved in that, can't you? If your league wants to hold a recognized tournament, get in touch with the WFTDA. But right now we're into true or false.
Ooh. Hydra was the first president of the WFTDA. Is that true or false? Get your answers in, folks.
What do you think, Twitch? Is this true or is this false? Twitch thinks we speak of the truth.
It is true. Hydra from Texas Roller Girls was the first president from 2006 to 2007. And for those of you in the know, the trophy that is awarded to the winner of the WFTDA Championships is known as the Hydra.
Right, another true and false for you. Every member in your league needs to have passed the WFTDA minimum skills requirements, MSRs. Is this true or false?
Okay, well, what is true is that 90% of the Twitch chat right now is about dogs, and I'm here for it.
And Laredo, you're with me. I didn't know whether I was allowed to say Hail Hydra, I'll be honest with you. I'll be honest, I really wanted to say it. So is this true or false?
It is false. The minimum skills requirements establish minimum skating skill requirements for all skaters passing in WFTDA sanctioned interleague.
Well, how did you do on the quiz, Twitch? Did you do all right? I don't think I did very well at all.
I think you smashed it, Riggs. I think you smashed it.
There's one or two, but thank God Sven's sitting next to me. That's all I got to say. Our producer Sven, who has been giving us all of those excellent information so far. But what have we got now?
We've got an upcoming raffle, so make sure you are registered for Twitch so that you can join us in the chat and enter our raffle. Get excited.
Get excited right now. You've got to be in the chat to do it. So we're going to take a look at some of our final moments of WFTDA Roller Derby, and we're going to be back with you in just a few minutes. Okay, welcome back, friends. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to run a raffle for a watch pass on this weekend's Cup, the 2019 European Continental Cup on WFTDA.tv. So what you need to do is you can enter by using the command !Helsinki in the chat, and we'll keep that opportunity open for 2 minutes. On your marks, get set, go!
So that is !Helsinki, H-E-L-S-I-N-K-I. And whilst we've got that raffle open for 2 minutes, we've got some exciting news about championships, which are going to be held in Montreal, Quebec this year. We're excited to offer Team Indigenous and Jewish Roller Derby a platform to showcase We Are Nation, a game without borders. Both of those teams have been doing just some exceptional work on the community-based aspect, particularly of roller derby. And that game will stream free on WFTDA.tv on Saturday, November 16th, live from Montreal. So do mark your diaries. That's November 16th. As I said, there are two teams without borders. They continue to challenge all of us in the WFTDA to do better, like to make our sport better, to make our community better. We really want to acknowledge their hard work, and we hope to share these amazing teams with as many viewers as possible. Please spread the word on social media and mark Saturday, November 16th in your diary.
Absolutely. Quick, get yourselves in there. !Helsinki.
Lots of people jumping on. Lots of compliments on my jacket. Thank you very much.
I mean, I like the fact that somebody felt the need to reassure me that my jacket was like unforeseen consequences. Thank you. But I can't. I mean, I'm being out-sparkled somewhat by Loud and Queer here.
I mean, to be fair, Riggs, you always out-dapper me, so I think we're neutral.
I mean, you're about the shimmer and the sparkle, and I'm all about the dapper.
I mean,
what we do.
Yeah, I mean, it's not about us, but we do appreciate the comments and the compliments very much. Loads of people jumping on. We've only got a little bit of time left on this raffle. Get your entry in there super quick.
So we've got about 45 seconds before the half. Second half resumes, and of course it is only a 10-point game, and the pendulum shifted so many times in that first half. As I said, you know, we started off with Auld Reekie with a streak, then it was a Dublin streak, then there was a little bit of back and forth, and Auld Reekie really closed out the first half with four lead jams, and they held Dublin scoreless in all of those.
I said streak so many times, I keep thinking we're talking about Snapchat, and I'm just like, I feel like I'm down with the youth and the kids.
Can I tell you something?
Yes, Riggs.
I've never downloaded Snapchat. I have no idea how it works.
I love you so much.
I look 12, but I'm a little bit older.
We have dashing Trudy Snow and Charlotte Patterson taking the stars at the start of this second half. The penalty box is mercifully empty.
So we started the first period with dashing Trudy Snow versus Charlotte Patterson, and that is the way we open up period two. Let's see who wins this one. It was dashing Trudy Snow who got lead last time, but pushing up front, Charlotte Patterson wants revenge in the opening jam.
Snowy just adjusting her knee pads a little bit there, has to reset, but dances around the outside, picks up lead status for Dublin.
Dashing to the pack.
See what you did there, Riggs.
Oh, yeah.
She's such a cool and collected jammer with just years of experience. And right now, she is going to be facing off against Just Little, who has received the star pass for Auld Reekie.
And all that roller derby is very exciting, but at Slamity99, congratulations on winning the watch pass.
Oh, Slamity, if that's who I think it is, I know them, so congratulations.
Oh, so we're all going around theirs? We're going around theirs for a watch pass.
I've already bought my watch pass, Riggs. I'm really excited to watch the WFTDA postseason.
So, Sasha is on the line for Auld Reekie going up against Greenhall Coney.
And we have a really tight pack, but Greenhall Cooney managing to leap around the outside, picks up lead for Dublin. So Dublin making a really strong statement in this second half.
So Sasha is picking up a penalty and is off to the penalty box. And that was a high block that sent her there.
A high block is when you hit an opposing skater kind of in the neck or head area. That is not a legal contact zone, which explains why you don't see roller derby players punching each other in the face on track. It's not that kind of contact sport.
Those elbows and all of that, they're myths. Those are myths about roller derby. This is just great, clean, full contact sport. And, oh, that physicality just opened up a fantastic line there for Dublin, allowing Greenhall Cooney to go through for four.
But yeah, 4 points, but Sasha De Boer Pisgah is back on track now. So a great power kill there from Auld Reekie, holding Greenhall Cooney to only that one scoring pass.
So no pass, no penalty, which means that one of the players, Greenhall Cooney, didn't pass legally, so had to, only gets the 3 points on that one.
In the meantime, we've had a star pass to simply the beast of Auld Reekie, who is now battling a two-wall.
Oh, but what a two-wall. Look at this work. It is fabulous. Have to let her go, though.
That is Maniha, one of those blockers, who is really just all over the Dublin defense. She seems to be everywhere. Jam comes to an end with 11 on the jam for Dublin, taking them to an even 70. Auld Reekie holding out 45.
A really strong start from Dublin, and I have to ask whether Auld Reekie got much left in the tank. As I said, that game against Perth, if you watched it earlier, was hella physical.
Hella physical. Just a quick update on the chat. Of course, we have given that watch pass away, but fear not, friends, we do have another watch pass to give away. I believe that's the one for the duration of this weekend, and given the standard of games, it's a fantastic prize, so do stick with us. We'll be giving that away after this second period.
And if you like some of the stats that we are being given by our lovely producer, Sven, then you might be the kind of person who wants to follow along with live game updates and matchups at stats.wftda.com. You can forecast the game results, keep up with who's playing who when, and see how this weekend's events affect the live ranking. All stats, all at stats.wftda.com.
After 40, almost 40 seconds of play, Emka has managed to pick up lead status for Auld Reekie. Vegan Fox having to battle four Auld Reekie blockers. That is not a fun place to be.
No, we've seen with a lot of these jammers that they can keep the speed on them, then they have an amazing way of getting through the pack. But if you can catch them, the containment often does follow really nicely, as we're seeing here with Auld Reekie.
Jammers, of course, not just fast, but strong as anything. I mean, look at Vegan Fox go. She is moving those three Auld Reekie blockers. And there's three of them. There's only one of her.
MK has recycled, is back at the exit of turn four. And is also doing battle with a lovely triangle of blockers who are determined to keep them in. But talking of determined to stay in, Vegan Fox, they're so strong on the line.
Auld Reekie deciding to call off the jam and understanding that those Dublin blockers was just too strong for that go around. But Emka did pick up 3 points on that last pass, which will add or take Auld Reekie's total, to 48 points. That's a 22-point differential. Hello to anyone joining us in the chat or just welcoming us back after halftime. I think Weary Bard 66, I think it's the first time seeing you in the chat, so do welcome.
So we've got Charlotte Patterson out there for Auld Reekie going up against dashing Trudy Snow. And both jammers are locked in battle with the blockers right now. Offense being offered up front by Dublin.
And you're seeing, someone was commenting on this in the chat earlier, Dublin particularly doing a lot of hand bracing. So bracing hand to hand rather than hand to arm, which gives them a bit more reach and coverage of the track. Dashing Trudy Snow with lead status for Dublin, weaving her way through some discombobulation on track there for Auld Reekie. Doesn't even have to touch their blockers to pick up 4 points.
And only has three Auld Reekie blockers to face, and Crazy Legs is in the box right now.
Charlotte Patterson really struggling against this Dublin ball, which is no no disrespect at all, because that Dublin wall is as well drilled as you can find at this level of derby. They are glued together at the back of the pack right now. And Charlotte is just tenacious and grinding away at that wall.
That was a lovely moment of confusion there. That just allowed Dash and Trudy Snow to just sneak on through as a penalty was picked up on the other side of the track. And Dash and Trudy Snow is the highest scoring jammer now for Dublin.
This is Dublin's highest scoring jam so far. That will be 12 in total, and Auld Reekie hold scoreless. What a showing there from the Irish team.
Is that Sven will correct us if we're wrong, but I think that's the highest jam of the game so far, as 11 points in the first half was the highest scoring jam we had. So dashing through the snow, and I get the big thumbs up from Sven that says, yes, dashing through the snow, setting records.
I like that Cammy Tazzy headed to the jam line doing a bit of a wee dance there. They really do love playing roller derby, and it's fun. This sport is fun. It's really important to emphasize that to our viewers and listeners. Like, this is the most fun you can have on eight wheels. And I have the most fun ever just talking about it. So do get involved if you're not already, and spread the word if you are.
So Kamatazi taken back by Locock there, but now has to do battle with the Dublin blockers once more.
Greenall Cooney trying to find space on the track, and in the midst of that, Cammy Tazzy picks up lead.
Took nearly a full 30 seconds there, but we have a star pass for Dublin as well. That's only the second of the game, I believe, and that's Locock picking up the star pass for the first time.
Cammy Tazzy, in the meantime, with 4 points on the jam. And she flies into this wide old Dublin tripod, who is going to take her all the way back into turn two.
Rewind, and there we go. Kamatazi upended there. And we are gonna get a penalty.
Yeah, a Dublin blocker heading off to the box for what will probably have been a low block causing that trip. Kamatazi with 4 more points, and Brudoli Locock is through for 4 of her own.
Slamity, that is why you deserve a watch pass, just helping out folks in the chat room like that. Auld Reekie are, in fact, from Edinburgh, representing. In fact, we have a team from each of the home nations representing this weekend, I believe.
We do. We have Tiger Bay Rollers from Wales. We have Auld Reekie Roller Derby from Scotland. And now I'm trying to remember what other teams
it's
we have.
Central City from Birmingham.
There we go, that's the one. And of course, elsewhere in European Roller Derby at this tournament, we have Antwerp Roller Derby, Kallio Rolling Raybar Host League, Dock City Rollers, and we have Perth Roller Derby all the way from Australia. So a truly international tournament.
So scores right now as we are in this timeout. Auld Reekie on 60, Dublin 26 points ahead right now.
So we're just having a quick update from our fantastic producer, Sven will be famous, about penalties. So in roller derby, each player can accrue a maximum of 7 penalties. If you accrue 7 penalties, then you foul out of the game. You are not allowed to be replaced, so there's no substitutions as there might be in other sports. You are simply not allowed back on track anymore. At the moment, the only player in any real danger is Chancleta from Dublin Roller Derby, who is on 4 penalties. You can also, in serious circumstances, have a penalty upgraded to an expulsion if the officials feel that the action was particularly egregious. Oh, so that the contact was excessive, for instance.
Sorry, just getting all excited there because we had a bit of defensive jamming happening from number 77, Charlotte Patterson, who just helped hit out Dashing Through the Snow and allowed their pivot to recycle. Charlotte Patterson now completes the initial pass, as we mentioned before, has to do that again. And I think there's going to be some penalties being called here. So it looks like a back block is being picked up by Charlotte Patterson. So now Ono Power Jam is dashing through the snow and a beautiful pirouette sees her out of the pack.
She is an incredibly graceful skater and makes everything she does look so effortless. Dublin now lining up on the inside line to effect a offensive sweep. Trudy comes into the outside and is forced down and out, but pops back up and attacks the pack once more. Jess Little putting in some work. Oh, and it looks like dashing Trudy Snow is off to the box for a multiplayer. Do you want to explain what's happening right now, Riggs, with the jammers?
So the jammers, we have to have a jammer on track. So what happens is that if one is in the box already, when the other one goes there, they will sit for the same amount of time as the first jammer sat for. So all's fair, but we do have to release one jammer as soon as the other one goes into the box. But as I said, we'll only sit for the same amount of time.
Yes, so for instance, if a jammer had sat 10 seconds and then the other jammer comes in, that jammer will only sit 10 seconds. It also means that whoever had lead status, if a jammer goes to the box having had lead status, they lose that. Therefore, they lose the ability to call off the jam, and we have a 2-minute jam.
Right there, that was some excellent work from Mania, who just did a brilliant job to force the recycle there on the Auld Reekie jammer.
Nice little high fives there from Dashing Trudy Snow to her opposing blockers there, which is one of the lovely things about roller derby, the camaraderie you have on and off the track.
So I think it's just clicked for me, but Nee, who's been watching, wants us to do a little bit of a shout out to his bro, Raj, who's 40 this weekend, or today, in fact. So happy birthday, Raj. And Nee, if you are who I'm thinking of, keep laughing and keep that comedy up.
And we're just having unforeseen consequences. Ask, is that the second or third jammer multiplayer? That is the second. I think that's one per team. Sven will correct me. It is. No? Oh, both from Dublin. Oh, thanks, Sven. This is why we need you. And it is interesting because I think you're going to get more multiplayers when you see jammers using tactics such as shirt whips, which we have been able to see from our vantage point, which aren't always possible to see when you're watching from above, as you mostly are.
So as we go into this next jam, it's Vegan Fox versus Sasha.
Vegan Fox trying the outside line, but not quite successful. She's patient. She will go all the way back behind Simply the Beast.
Great awareness there from Sasha to know that she didn't have to go all the way back with the entire pack there, just had to go back on in front of any of the blockers that were in front of her when she came off the track. And that has put her in position to be eligible for points right now. Oh my day, dodging, dipping, diving and ducking on that inside line to sneak on through for 4 full points for Auld Reekie.
Now, Auld Reekie with only 16 points to go if they want to catch up Dublin. It'll be interesting to see how they play this tactically. You know, if they get lead, are they going to run the jams long? Are they going to do what we call the hit and quit jams, where they will call off the jam after 1, 2, 3, or 4 points, you know, just a handful? I'm not a soothsayer. I can't predict the future, Riggs, but, you know, I think one of those two things is definitely going to happen.
I mean, I know I can't predict the future because my bracket is so dead.
Oh, don't talk about the bracket,
it's extinct.
Riggs.
It's actually extinct. I think there were only 15 brackets left earlier. I dread to think how many are left by now. But Green Horhuni is left out there doing battle with Auld Reekie, looking for room on the outside. The blocker could not stay in barrier to Green Hall. Gets the no pass, no penalty.
No, that's no. A cut track. I did see that. She no pass, no penalty on Jess Little, but cut on the two other Auld Reekie blockers. So it's a power jam for Auld Reekie and Emka.
And this is exactly what they need to get right back in this game. There is just 16 points in this.
But look at Dublin go to work. They're splitting into two pairs and filling these gaps, now reforming together. And Emka, just everywhere she goes, is just finding a white shirt. Unbelievable power kill going on right now from Dublin.
Dublin just standing up to all of those offensive moves. And look at Emka, just almost through there. But Dublin able to hit out. That was 1-6-9, Lowcock.
And penalty expired now. Greenhall could...
and he sat those 30 seconds. She is now back in play.
And penalties haven't been a huge issue in this second half. 5 picked up by Auld Reekie, 6 picked up by Dublin. And Greenhawk only there just dropping blockers off to the side. It might have been Argy Bargy, in fact, who helped out there.
All the action happening in the straightaway right now. It feels like we haven't moved for years, but now a little bit of movement coming in as you see the pivots bridging the pack.
I can't see Emka's face, but I would imagine it's a very pleading look towards their pivot. Like, I know you're busy bridging, but oh my days, help me out.
Bangers of Auld Reekie being lost to the box. Greenhawk Cooney completes the initial pass. Oh no, this foot. Yeah, the initial pass as the jam comes to an end. So what a grinding jam.
Absolute sensational jam. But you're absolutely right, in the Twitch chat room, all the love for our NSOs. And in fact, I'm just going to tell you who they are right now, because we haven't mentioned them so far. Kiravi, Sticks and Stoner, Hoff and Roll, X-Ray, Ted, Agricola, Maharalyn Manson, Jack Franca, Fratura, Goosebumps, and Marlene Detrick are our NSOs today, and I are doing a fantastic job.
Charlotte Patterson and Dashing Trudy Snow, quite a familiar matchup going on right now, and we're settling once again into this blocker-based grind.
So we see Crazy Legs going off to the penalty box there for Auld Reekie.
Snowy pushing up ahead, and she does pick up lead status for Dublin. This differential is still so close. Snowy's got to stay clean. And she does. Lovely little apex jump over the inside.
Oh, defensive jamming from Charlotte Patterson, who puts on the burners to try and catch up and force Dashing Through the Snow to call the jam. So back to a 20-point game with those 4 points put up by Dublin.
Shout out to CQ underscore Mia, who is here to support Dublin. Do let us know in the chat who you're supporting, even if you're joining us for the first time or if you don't have any team allegiances. Let us know who your team is this game, you know, who's impressed you the most. All's fair in love and roller derby. We can all take sides for a game and be friends afterwards.
So Kamitazi is out on the line doing battle with the Dublin three wall right there. Vegan Fox up at the front of the pack, pushing hard. Offense being offered, but now the pack starts to spread. So has to go it alone somewhat.
Kamitazi really, really agile and throwing the shoulders in to this Dublin wall. But look at how they suck back and take her space. So she's not got a big run off.
Oh, Vegan Fox did some great work there. Just push, push, push. And then the space opened up. And Vegan Fox just put the burners on, but a huge impact with Miss Collie Check there.
But Vegan Fox finding space on the outside. And she's a jammer who, when she gets some speed up, as she's doing now, really uses that power to drive past and through walls.
Kamitazi has now exited the pack, completed the initial pass, and is going to be eligible for the points. But Dublin are wise to it. Vegan Fox calls it before Auld Reekie can pick up any points.
Just a few more shout outs in the chat. We've got Ketcher Ruber Pigman, what a name, who is saying, go on the DRD. So I'm assuming you're as a Dublin supporter there. Weary Bard 66, I like green, so go Auld Reekie. Fair play. You know, if you can't decide, pick your favorite, pick your color. And a big thank you to those who are giving us some love, to everyone on the day's work and all weekend. So the tournament oversight, head officials and so on. And to Unforeseen Consequences, who are here to support officials, volunteers, and especially the announcers. Ah,
we need that support.
I like that. Whoever you are, I'm hoping I know you, but we appreciate you, we see you, and we love you. Oh, Riggs, what is happening here?
Well, I tell you what is happening. Greenhawk Cooney is out of the pack and is your lead jammer as Auld Reekie lose a blocker to the box. So only 3 to face on this scoring pass now for Greenhawk Cooney.
Sasha DeBoyle-Pisco has been drawn back by Maniha.
And Little is trying to draw back Greenhawk Cooney, but was denied quite as extensive a recycle as they would have liked. Oh, and we're going backwards again.
I feel like with all the play that's been happening in this particular straightaway, this game, the floor's going to get worn down on this side. We're going to have a tilted track. That's how science works, right?
That is exactly how science works. I mean, I'm going to say that because you're the teacher and I am not. But here we go. It is all happening up at the front of the pack. Greenhorn Cooney has got two left to drive through. Puts the shoulder down and gets on through for those four very hard-earned points as we see a star pass now.
And that's to Jess Little, who in my very humble opinion is one of the most underrated skaters in Scotland. Such a seasoned skater, but unfortunately no time to see her jam as the jam is called off. Dublin now at 108, Auld Reekie at 74. Dublin really shifting up the momentum a little bit the last few jams. And we've got under 10 minutes to go.
Wow, where's that gone? That has gone very quick. Lots of conversations about the floor here. And I have to say, you know, it does look shiny, but we haven't seen any issues from the gameplay going on.
The last time I was here for Finvitational, which is also hosted by Kallio Rolling Rainbow, I popped on some skates and had a wee kind of little roller disco skate around the floor. And I can tell you, it is a fast floor. It is good and fun.
So absolutely making it even more impressive when you see these jammers being locked down by these blockers, plowing hard on this lovely floor we've got right here. But it is absolutely a scrum right there on the inside line. It all starts to break apart now.
Hard to believe there's only 9 or 10 players on track. It looks so crowded. Dashing Trudy Snow with a balletic leap over the apex. Once again, she is lead for Dublin.
So just a little bit of penalty concern for the captain of Auld Reekie, and Crazy Legs, I believe, are sitting on 5 penalties now. A nice mix of forearms and direction.
It's good to have variety.
Absolutely.
I had unforeseen consequences in the chat saying they'll give me a hug the next time they see me. And I really hope, I imagine you are someone I know, but otherwise I'm very afraid. Auld Reekie scoreless for 5 jams. It's 5 seems to be the number of scoreless or streaks this game, doesn't it? We've just had the back and forth. It's a real pendulum momentum going on right now in this game.
So it's Vegan Fox versus Kamatazi, and Kamatazi at the back of the pack doing battle with Dublin at tripod as we see Vegan Fox pushing hard up front, and they get the push out, and Auld Reekie do the big run back to take Fox back behind the pivot line. Crazy Legs rejoins the action and gets stuck straight in on the offense. And that does, in fact, set Kamatazi free to pick up lead. Great work from Crazy Legs there.
Vegan Fox has taken the star off, so perhaps looking to affect the star pass at some point. But she's just got to work past these Auld Reekie blockers first.
The Kamatazi picking up lead there ends the Dublin 4 lead streak that they had going on. And as we said, we see that pendulum swing back towards Auld Reekie.
Can they turn it around in 7 minutes though?
Wow, and as we were talking, number 11, Crazy Legs, has picked up another penalty, another forearm. Just to add to the mix. So in danger now of fouling out of the game. We've got 6 minutes and 50 seconds. And Crazy Licks has been quite the blocker.
She's really, really like a glue blocker on track. Like, she keeps things together. So it could be critical for Auld Reekie if she fouls out now.
Dublin pivot in the box as well.
And still 23 seconds to go in what feels like the longest jam of my life. But Vegan Fox makes it out on the initial, and Kamatazi decides, I'm not going to risk that. I'll take what I can get, which is 4 points. And that is an even 30 for the differential, now separating these two teams in favour of Dublin.
And that is not a huge lead. It's not a comfortable lead in this situation. We've got time for a good couple of jams. So let's see what Charlotte Patterson can do for Auld Reekie going up against Greenhorn Cooney. And yet again, Dublin suck up that space from Charlotte Patterson back behind the jam line. Oh, hips went in there and it just caught Charlotte Patterson off balance, all perfectly legal.
The tenacity of these players who take these huge hits to the floor and then pop right back up as if nothing unforeseen has happened never ceases to amaze me, even as someone who plays derby.
So we have two tripods in operation now, doing their best to lock down. Offense is offered and Greenhawk only takes it and takes lead at the same time. The Dublin now in control of this jam. But Charlotte Patterson hops the apex, comes on through to try and force Dublin to call this before they can pick up too many points.
Dublin losing Valdemort to the box and bangers for Auld Reekie also in attendance for a penalty.
Fable, you are absolutely right. Today has been a day of blocker beauty. We have seen some incredible blocking so far today. Like I said, that jam start straight away has been a channel of just jam of death. They've just been locked down and had to fight so hard to get even to the entrance of turn one.
I think that speaks to the evolution of roller derby as a game in general, though. I think it used to begin, it was all about speed, and now it's become a game that's so much about strategy. And the jammers are absolutely phenomenal athletes. I cannot emphasize this enough. But it's the blockers who are putting the show on, I think, this tournament as much as anything. They're really showing everything they've learned in the regular season, in this postseason tournament, how they've stuck together and grown.
What I really love is every time the jammers raise their game, learn themselves some new tricks, the blockers go away and work out how to shut all that down. And now what will happen as we go into the next season is the jammers will find some new tricks.
We got to hope so, but throwing their own tricks in the meantime, or attempting to, dashing Trudy Snow, who picks up the no pass, no penalty, out of the pack, looks a little bit winded, but she's tenacious as you like, and in scoring position for Dublin.
And wisdom from the chat room there, Lightning Slim, pointing out that the defense to offense transition is where a lot of the action is happening. And you're absolutely right. For those of you who tuned in earlier and saw Perth play, they were fantastic at that switch from D to O. I would totally recommend going back and seeing that. But yes, this is absolutely what is making the difference in this game right here.
So we are in a timeout called by Auld Reekie. So we would like to remind you that at the end of this game, we are going to be giving away another WFTDA.tv watch pass. So please do make sure that you stick around for that. And if you're enjoying roller derby and want to see it live, our 2019 International Championships take place November 15th to 17th in Montreal, Quebec. You can get all the information on tickets and locations at wftda.com/champs. Where, of course, the Team Indigenous and Jewish roller derby game that we mentioned earlier will be taking place. And I'm really, really excited to watch that free stream on WFTDA.tv on Saturday, November 16th. I'm saying it again so you can put it in your diaries, folks. It's going to be a really, really incredible game.
I join in this conversation, but they're talking about doggos. And there are doggo gifts and little images in Twitch chat, and it's... You know, that's how I like to fill my team timeouts, frankly, with doggos.
I'd like to fill my life with doggos.
More doggos, please.
Dogs, derby, and good pals. That is the life I lead, and it's the life I love. Such a privilege.
So, with the privilege of being on the jam start line right now is Vegan Fox for Dublin, going up against number 77, Charlotte Patterson for Auld Reekie. There is a blocker, a piece in the box, so this is going to be a very defensive start in this jam. And look at them right now. Just a massive melee in the middle of that straight away. And now they start to become defined packs. Interesting offense offered there. That was number 9, Mallory Powers.
We are at a standstill in turn 1. Stop motion at roller derby. Valdemort coming back from the box for Dublin. Will she shake it up? No, she just joins her wall, settles in to this grind. To be fair, if I were Dublin right now, I wouldn't be super fussed about taking a lot of risks in the pack, because looking at the score and the time they have left, they're in a comfortable position. So the key thing now is to stay clean.
Absolutely. There are 2 minutes left on this period clock. And I do just want to say we are an incredibly inclusive community. So cats are absolutely welcome at the roller derby. It's just they're not very good in the crowd, are they?
Just to clarify, folks, that's Riggs talking about the chat that's going on Twitch. There are, I can confirm, no felines on track. However, Charlotte Patterson is on track and she is lead after a grueling minute and a half almost battling the pack. She is lead for Auld Reekie.
Oh, big hits from Crazy Leg, took Vegan Fox out right there, and some big hits right at the end of that jam on Charlotte Patterson.
Yeah, she went in pretty hard with her shoulder there onto number 8 of Dublin. But they are both up and skating back to their respective benches. A good chance to just give a shout out to our medics who are in attendance all weekend. They are here as the skating officials are to keep us safe. And Charlotte did call off the jam there of her own volition and while she was on the floor, which is important because it means if she did that and skated back to the bench under her own steam, she can come back on in her usual rotation. If the jam is called off by the officials for injury because they see that a player is indisposed, that player cannot return to the track for at least 3 jams, and that's part of the rules of roller derby, because it is a contact sport and we want to keep everybody safe and make sure that they're all kind of, all the limbs are attached and everything's still there when you head back on track.
Absolutely. So if you've been enjoying what you've been seeing today and you want to see more excellent roller derby, please visit wftda.tv/watch-pass to find out how you can watch the rest of this event and our championships in November live from your very comfortable sofa.
Yeah, we are really happy to have you on this free stream courtesy of Twitch. But for more information on how to play roller derby, the rules, penalties and this event, you can visit wftda.com/new. And we're all still learning about roller derby. I mean, I've been in this sport for a number of years now, and I'm still learning. Shout out to Lightning Slim on the chat, who is crushing hard on Vegan Fox's ability to accelerate from a cruising position. You and me both, Slim. I think I'm just crushing on Vegan Fox's ability to do literally anything on skates, to be perfectly fair.
All perfectly acceptable and reasonable, frankly.
And Lightning Slim putting in an exclamation mark. Poutine. We're not in Montreal
we're
yet, Slim.
We're not there. We're still loving life here in Vasila, in Helsinki, Finland, with Kallio Rolling Rainbow, who have hosted a wonderful Continental Cup thus far, full of upsets and close games. And you are going to want to stay tuned for the rest of this.
Speaking of staying tuned, after this game, we have the last game of today. That's coming up at 7:30 p.m. local time. And that will be Central City Roller Derby versus Tiger Bay Brawlers. And that is going to be a bruiser. And I mean that in the best possible way.
Mm.
So do make sure you stay tuned. If you have access to the WFTDA.tv stream.
And if you don't, what do you need to do? You need to go to WFTDA. I nearly went all very 2000 on you then and went www. But no, WFTDA.tv/watch-pass. You can pick yourself up one of those if you don't win it in the raffle at the end of the day. And just as I was saying that, Crazy Legs adds one more forearm to their penalty tally and is fouled out of the game.
That means she has to leave the hall. She can't remain on her team's bench. But with just over a minute left on the period clock, she won't be waiting for them for long. A forearm called on number 7, Jess Little. And in the confusion and the melee, Green Hall Cooney picks up lead status for Dublin.
Auld Reekie did have a pack deficit as that jam opened up. There were 2 in the box to start with. That did help Green Hall. And this is a power jam now for Green Hall Cooney. And that was a low block picked up there by Charlotte Patterson.
Yeah, Patterson heading off to the box with a kind of philosophical shrug expression on her face, kind of going, well, there's not much more I can do except wait. Dublin choosing to goat at Temple of Doom in the back of the pack.
And there is a track cut picked up by Greenhawk Cooney. So we will play a bit of Jammer Switcheroo as we head into the last 20 seconds of this period. There's still a minute left on the jam clock though.
So as we mentioned before, this means that Greenhawk Cooney has lost her lead status as she's gone to the box. And that means that Charlotte Patterson and Greenhawk Cooney, when she returns, will be running this jam to the full 2 minutes.
So two Dublin blockers off to the box as Charlotte Patterson goes on through to complete the initial. We've got 35 seconds left on the jam clock. The period clock is dead now. So as soon as this jam ends, and it will run the natural 2 minutes, allowing Auld Reekie to just close down that differential ever so slightly.
Both teams standing at their benches, arms around each other, as is quite typical for teams in the last jam. And this is what I love about Royal Derby as well. Every team plays right till the end. There's no such thing as giving up in Derby.
Absolutely not. You play to the very last moment. And talking of that, here it comes. It is all over here in Helsinki in Finland. And Dublin take the win in game five.
We're just going to wait for the final whistle, which will make the score on your screens official. The unofficial score, 127 to Dublin, 90 to Auld Reekie. But, oh my goodness, what a game. What a game, Riggs, what a game.
My word, it was fantastic. And as we said, that momentum shift was just unstoppable. It just kept going back and forth. The streaks weren't as solid as they were in the first half, but it did flip back and forth very, very nicely.
I have to say, I think the way in which Dublin adapted to the confusion from some of Auld Reekie on the track was just really, really smart. I think that it's tiny little details that as experienced skaters you pick up, you know, you notice a player's head turn or switch, you notice a player go off for a penalty, and you capitalize on that so well. And I really think that's what made the difference for Dublin.
It did indeed. So Dublin have put themselves in position to be in game 10 tomorrow at Sunday at 3 o'clock here, Helsinki time. And they will play the winner of, I believe it is, Central City versus Tiger Blay. And that will be to decide fifth and sixth place. So, but coming up, as we said, next we have got that Central City and Tiger Blay game. But
just giving a quick shout out to we are going to now raffle off a pass for the season bundle, which includes archives from all the cups and playoffs, plus live access to this weekend and our championships event in November. So essentially you get access to all the rest of this weekend, the championships, and all the tournaments that have happened so far in this post-season. You are going to use the command !Finland to enter, and our 2 minute contest period starts now. So that is the !Finland to enter, F-I-N-L-A-N-D. You have 2 minutes.
Oh, so that was a fantastic game. And don't forget, we've got more games coming up on Twitch for you. You can check the schedule out at she says that. I've completely forgotten. Oh, that is it. WFTDA.tv/Twitch. That is how you will know which of our games are running on there. And so that you can too get involved with the chat and be in with an opportunity to win one of the watch passes that we give away. So !Finland, get those in right now, because that is going to close any second now.
And that is a $50 value for this watch pass, so really you'd be doing yourself a favor to enter. Of course, if you do not win this raffle, you can go to WFTDA.tv and purchase a pass for yourself. I guarantee you it is 100% worth it. I've bought them in the past. I've bought them for this season because it's going to be an absolute corker of a tournament.
Oh, can't wait for champs. Champs is gonna be amazing. So You aren't, as much as I admire your endeavours in the chat room, exclamation mark, Finland doggos is not going to get you a watch pass, nor is it going to get you a doggo.
Also, make sure you're spelling Finland with one N. So it's exclamation mark, F-I-N-L-A-N-D. So no double N's. Lining Slim, more like Winland, am I right? Oh, Slim, I miss your announcing. I mean, I know you still announce, but I just miss you.
Standards to which we aspire, and Lightning Slim is those. Absolutely. I think you've still got a couple of seconds to get your exclamation mark Finland in there to see if you can win the raffle.
And just coming up after this, I think Riggs already mentioned, but just to hype it up a bit more, we have Central City Roller Derby from Birmingham in the UK, and we have Tiger Bay Rollers from Wales. So two teams that are super familiar with each other.
This is going to be very tasty. Okay, so the giveaway has closed, and it is at Overlord Mark, who has won the watch pass. Congrats to Overlord Mark. And
I'm last second by the looks of it as well.
Absolutely.
One of the last entries.
That was fantastic work there. And I might not be able to tell you what to do, okay, but I can give good advice. And my advice to you is to get yourself to WFTDA.tv/watch-pass to make sure you can see Central City versus Tiger Bay. You do not want to miss this.
In the meantime, we are going to take a break and recover from all that excitement and let the announcers for the last game of the first day of European Continental Cup 2019 takeover. It has been an absolute joy and a privilege to call this game with you, Riggs, as always. And we'd like to give a huge shout out to our producer, Sven Will Be Famous, for keeping us on track and sounding vaguely intelligent. I've been Loud and Queer, signing out. Have a fantastic evening and the rest of the tournament.
I'm Riggs. Take care. Goodbye.